So I grew up in Tampa, Florida. I was originally born in Minnesota, but when I was 6, my family and I moved to Florida. Second grade was kind of when I really figured out that I could sing, and I had a music teacher named Mr. Cavalier. I'll never forget him, he was the best. He was holding solos for a recital, and he never heard anybody sing in the class, and we all had to stand up and audition for these solos and stuff. And he heard me sing, and it was funny because he didn't really say anything when I started singing, and I sat back down, and then at the end he goes, "I want to see you after class." And I was thinking to myself, oh God, what did I do? Did something really bad come out? I don't know. So I saw him after class, and he was like, "You really can sing, and I can see you doing this as a career, and you know, I really believe in you." And so I was like, wow, really? Okay, well, yeah, okay. So I did the solo for the recital, and that's kind of how it all started. My mom's probably gonna laugh at this. I used to sing in bed at night. Like, I wouldn't go to sleep. It was really funny because I would sing really loud and forget that my parents were home. So I just sang and sang. I think I made my own song up in the middle of the night, and my dad came in and was like, "Gabby, stop singing." And I got really quiet, and then he goes, "What were you singing?" And I'm like, "I don't know." And he goes, "Did you make that up?" And he's like, and I was like, "Yeah." And he goes, "That was really good." But he goes, "But go to bed." I started my freshman year in high school, and there was this contest called the Quaker Chewy Superstar Contest that my mom saw online. It was a singing contest for online submissions, and you can make this 1-minute video submission with Nick Jonas being a part of it, and if you won, you know, he could produce a song and write a song for you, and you could go to LA and record it. And so I was like, God, yeah, that's a great idea. So we recorded it, the little tiny little video submission. We had like 4 choices of songs, "Nothing on You" by Bruno Mars, and I was like, oh yeah, I could do something with that. So submitted it, you had to get everybody to vote for you. So I got, you know, the school, my friends, and went around to my local restaurants and, you know, post pictures and stuff like that and asked for them to vote. I was sleeping, and all of a sudden I hear this screaming from my mom, and I'm like, what the heck is going on? So I like run into the kitchen, I'm like, what's wrong? And she's like, "You won! You won! Oh my God, you won!" When I walked up to meet him for the first time, there was a bunch of people in the room that were like filming, and I was like, oh my God, this is even worse now because I'm like super nervous to meet him anyways. But yeah, so we walked in and I met him, and played me the song that he had written for me, which was insane and so incredible, and I was like, I love it. I was like, really? Okay, well then let's play it and get used to it and then record it. And then we just kind of went home. I kind of all made the family decision that this is something I really want to do, and they believe in me and I believe in myself, and I know that something great can come from this. So 3 or 4 months later, we moved to LA. Working with different producers and kind of getting different sounds out of different people, because every producer you work with kind of has a different direction. Some are more R&B, some are more dance and stuff like that. So just working with different people, that's what I've been doing pretty much, and acting alongside that, and doing commercials and stuff like that, which has been really, really cool, and just kind of extending myself as an artist and kind of growing. Most of my songs that I have either come from like small ideas, so I'll write down a tiny bit, like maybe a verse or maybe a chorus that kind of sounds good in my head, and then I'll come back to it. So it'll be a lot of scribbles and things like that. For me, I like to write about the experiences that I'm having, whether they're good or bad or whatever it may be, and then also just relatable things that, you know, some people really never get the chance to talk about with other people, that, you know, once they hear the song, like, oh my gosh, I've experienced the same exact thing as that person.